Good morning and welcome back this Wednesday to another video. My name is Dustin Quillen. If you're new to this channel, please hit that subscribe button. I'm a tattoo artist that does watercolor flash painting, among other things. And today, since it's the day before Thanksgiving, I thought I'd go over some of the books that I'm thankful for. So let's get started. First off, we have Color and Light, A Guide for the Realist Painter by James Gurney. If you're unfamiliar with James Gurney, he's a fantastic artist. He created the Dinotopia series of books. And in this book, you're going to find a lot of different helpful information when it comes to using forms of light and shadow and color to make your artwork more dynamic, more realistic, or to get whatever effects you're going for. So you're going to get some color theory in here. You're going to get a lot of information on how to use shadow, the definition of different types of shadow, different atmospheric effects, and all that. And plus, there's a ton of amazing artwork from various different artists in here. So, I mean, there's a lot of stuff to learn, but there's also a lot of good inspiration. Definitely recommend this book, no matter what kind of art you're into. It's extremely useful. So that's the first one. And I've got a lot of different books here. Some of them are going to be more educational books like this one, giving different techniques, theories, and all that. And some of the other ones are just going to be books by artists that inspire me. So next up, we have a little book by an artist named Huck G, The Art of Huck G. And he does a lot of stuff with the vinyl, what are they called, the Dunny figures. And he does a lot of illustration too. So here's some of the cool dunnies that he's customized and different kind of vinyl art toys. There's a Hello Kitty there. And then here's some of his actual digital art. So I just find his art inspirational. Just love his style and the digital art. It's fantastic. One of my favorite artists, especially when it comes to toys. All right, so that's just one of the artists that I find inspirational. Now, here's a fantastic reference book, especially if you like pinup girls. 1,000 Pinup Girls. I got this one at a local bookstore. Don't know what that receipt is for. Oh, it's for a palette. But being a tattoo artist, it's always great to have good reference material in pinups. While not as popular as I'm sure they are in other places, I don't really do a whole lot of them. But it's good to have reference. You know, you can always go online, but really books are awesome as reference material. So, fantastic pinup book. This has got literally 1,000 pinup girls in it. It's pretty thick. Yeah, it wasn't too expensive, I don't think. It's a really good book. For anybody that loves Japanese style tattoo art and cats, I definitely recommend Mon Mon Cats. If you follow Horitomo on Instagram, you will see him post these a lot. And these cats are all done in watercolor, I believe. And this is a very popular one. This has been shared many, many times. But there are always these cats with images on them. Tattoos, usually. A lot of good rat pieces there. I love cats. And I love Japanese artwork. And so this was definitely a must-have for me. So that's another good book, Mon Mon Cats. Here's some other Japanese style artwork by Wendy Pham. If you follow her on Instagram, it is Wen Ramen. And this one has some neat packaging, but it's basically just a collection of some of her pieces and individual little, like, these are thick cardstock prints. I have a squirrel in my window right now. Oh, he went away. This one, the little hamster floating in the ramen bowl, the sea of ramen. But fantastic, again, great Japanese style artwork, and she's a phenomenal tattoo artist as well. I just love how she uses ramen in every single piece. It's pretty neat. No artist can know too much about color theory. Color is everything, and it really is, you know, unless you're a black and gray artist. But this book is going to go into a lot of just color theory information, and you know what? It's, you know, it's pretty helpful. It's great, especially if you're a beginner into it, but it's not really all that in depth. So good place to start. Great book, but you know, if you're kind of already experienced with a little bit of color theory, it might be too basic. So good book, definitely recommend it, but you know, it could use some more information. Up next, here's another good book by an artist that definitely well known in the tattoo industry, Joe Capobianco. Knock Yourself Out. Now, he does these, what they're referred to as capo girls. So another, you know, this, the pinup book would play in very well with a lot of his artwork that he does, because that's basically all he does. I'm sure he does tattoo a few other things, but it's almost always women. So you can get some insight into his style here. See a lot of his more sketchy stuff that goes all the way up to some more finished, finely rendered drawings. Good stuff. Here's another good color mixing book. Now, I haven't really done portraits much. This is kind of a book in preparation for that, so hoping it would help me out. I do want to start doing portraits soon. I am going to start doing portraits soon. Just need to find the time to do it. But, you know, you can't go wrong, like I said, with any number of instructional books. They're always going to give you something that you might not have seen somewhere else, usually. So this one's great just to get different skin tones. Oil, acrylic, and watercolor, so you can't go wrong with that one. This one is called Donata, the Art of Gerald Tidwell. Just another good tattoo artist. He does a lot of, it's more of a graphic style of art, not strictly tattoo related, but he's really good. Just another inspirational book. Sorry if I'm not taking too long on a lot of these books. I have a ton of them, and it would take me a while, so I don't spend too much time. These Old Blue Arms, Life and Work of Eamon Dietzel. Fantastic book. Again, this is another tattoo artist that I find inspiration from. He's more of an American traditional, because it's, you know, that or Japanese, pretty much what was around back then. A lot of good examples of his work. These are all his flash paintings. He did a ton of them. I mean, because back then you didn't order flash quite like you did now, or books from all the artists that are being put out. You pretty much just drew your own. And you went into the shop and you pointed at what you wanted, and then you got it. But this is a cool book because it goes into a lot of his biography. And it does provide a great number of references to his work. So if you're into stuff like that, definitely check it out. this is a very, very helpful book. Lettering Guide by BJ Betts. And there are several great lettering tattoo artists out there that have their own books. But this is the one that got me started into lettering. I don't do much lettering, but it's a great resource, especially if you want to hand draw it. You know, a lot of people can use any number of websites to pull fonts off of, but if you really want to make something cool, this is a fantastic reference. It shows all different kinds of lettering styles. And if you like this one, you find it helpful, he's got, like, I think 4 volumes of this book out now. Four different books. So, if you're into lettering, check out BJ Betts. He's amazing. Martin Lacasse, take what you want, give nothing back. This is all flash art by Martin Lacasse. Just another inspirational book. A lot of watercolor. I'm sure there's probably some acrylic in there too. I'm not sure exactly what he used. But all kinds of different styles, from American traditional to Japanese. Some a little bit more colorful, kind of neo-traditional or new schooly. Looking at Martin Lacasse. If you like new school, can't go wrong with Gunner. In the beginning, the sketches of Gunner. So he does a lot of stuff with people. I imagine he'd be very good at caricatures. And he definitely has his own style, which you can tell by looking at this artwork. But you know, again, it's inspiration. This is not meant to copy directly. If you find elements of artists you like, you can take them. What little elements, and add that into your art and try it, see if it works. If not, oh well, if it does, then maybe that can add something cool to your style. But definitely for inspiration. This is Oriental Menagerie, tattoo drawings by G. Cellularo. Fantastic Japanese artwork, and he included this mini print. He shows everything from more rough sketch art to a little bit more of the finished artwork, some posters that he's done, paintings. He's done quite a few posters for different conventions. This one, this big catfish, he actually has made into a shirt. It's pretty cool. Some tattoo art that he's done as well. Fantastic tattooer. Action cartooning. Written and illustrated by Ben Caldwell. This is really great if you're into drawing comics or any kind of dynamic poses, drawing the figure. You know, of course, it's from a more cartoon illustrative aspect, but very fun book. Definitely check it out. This is Threshold, Battles Within. This is a book by one of my favorite tattoo artists, David Tevenoff. And he definitely does like a neo-traditional, I would say, kind of artwork. This is a pretty big book, so I'll try to get it in there most as much as I can. He primarily uses spray paint, acrylic paint pens, and Copic markers, I believe. And he does stuff from tiny line drawings, stuff like this, to large paintings, to even murals, graffiti art, stuff like that. Fantastic artist. If you've not seen any of his artwork, he actually has a few videos on YouTube. He's one of the people that originally inspired me to start making art videos. So search him on YouTube. It's David Tevenoff, definitely worth looking into. This was a book he did on Kickstarter. I'm very happy with it. I've got another book of his too. Nick Baxter, Sharp Focus Realism in Oil. Nick Baxter is definitely one of my favorite tattoo artists. He has his own style. It's very painterly, I would say. And just an amazing oil painter. I mean, you look at this, this is an oil painting. Crazy. And he shows you some of the detail. This one goes into a lot of just the basic principles, the fundamentals, and the more advanced principles of oil painting. And then he even compares some of this to tattooing as well, the different types of brushes you can use versus the different types of tattooing needles. So if you're a tattoo artist and a painter, you need this book. You need it in your life. So awesome. Goes from the process of blocking in to modeling to detailing, etc. Amazing. I'm getting a big pile of books and they just fell over on the floor. The Art of Loesch, a look behind the scenes. Loesch is an amazing digital artist. She does a lot of stuff with on a Wacom or a Cintiq tablet. I believe it's just mostly digital that she does, though, but she is fantastic. This was from a Kickstarter she did a while ago. I don't know if it'll say in here. I guess, was when this was published, so last year. Definitely want to check out her work. She's fantastic. She does some more realistic stuff to some more illustrative. You know, I love the scenes that she does and the way she uses light and shadow and color and warm and cold on that side just to kind of lead the eye around. I mean, it's so amazing. She does really fantastic work. Look at that use of light to dark. You got the cold up top. It almost gives you this impression. Well, I'm sure it's supposed to, that she's underwater. It looks like lily pads. Up there at the top, you see some little air bubbles there. Just amazing. Definitely inspirational to me. And this book also goes over some good art principles. So, I mean, it's both instructional and inspirational. And she's actually got a new book coming out soon to deal with more of sketch art that she's done that shows some of her process. So, Loesch, check her out. Really good work. Next up, Light and Shadow, Monochromatic and Value-Based Approaches in Charcoal, Oil, and Ink by Ian Robert McCown. He is not only a fine artist, but a tattoo artist as well. So if you like working in black and gray, or monochromatic pieces, not all of these are black and gray, that is red and white on toned paper, then this is definitely a book you need to check out. It's pretty well written. You know, there's definitely some places where there are typos and things not capitalized where they should have been. I mean, some of it, as far as the writing goes, seems like maybe it was a little rushed. But a great book nonetheless. Great for techniques and good artistic principles. And of course, he's a fantastic artist. Great on both paper and skin. So definitely one to check out, especially if you like charcoal. Good book. Now this next one, I'm sure if you guys watch art videos on YouTube, you're familiar with this man, Mark Crilly. This is Mastering Manga with Mark Crilly. Now I used to do more manga style stuff or anime drawing many years ago when I was still in school. And I've always enjoyed Mark's drawing videos, so I wanted to support him and get this book, and it's full of fantastic information in regards to anime and manga artwork. So if you're into that, definitely check that book out. It's fantastic. And he's got several books out, so definitely check those out. Shout out to Mark. Next we have Making Faces, Drawing Expressions for Comics and Cartoons. This again is another good instructional book for comic style art, making very expressive faces. That's one thing that I've had problems with, especially with drawing faces, is just making them convey, you know, something without words. Because anybody can put, you know, a speech bubble up next to someone's head and try to make them sound angry, but to give them that look without using the words, to me, it's just so much better. So this is another great book for drawing. All right, I'm going to skip some of the rest of these because this has been a very long video. So I'll go over just a few more really, really important books that I like. This was another Kickstarter book, Masters of Anatomy. And, you know, it's pretty good. It goes through a ton of different artists, and it shows male and female drawings in their style. I think three of each, so. And they're pretty basic, you know, they're not usually gonna have clothing on them, just to show you the male and female form done in many different styles. So that's another good book, Masters of Anatomy. This one, of all the books, you know, if I had to pick just a couple books, this one would definitely be one to recommend. This is Figure Drawing for All It's Worth by Andrew Loomis. Now, you cannot go wrong with anything by Andrew Loomis. But if you need help with your figure drawing, then this is a great book to have. It's going to go over lines of action, various poses, a lot of good muscle group, perspectives. Fantastic. Sorry about that. So if you're wanting to draw people, this is one of the best books I can recommend. Definitely check that out. Let's see, I got several other books down here. I'm going to try not to go over all of them. Another good book, and you know, not even specifically this book, but this is a school textbook on human anatomy. You cannot go wrong with this. I mean, this is going to give you so much information on anatomy. You know, and a lot of it you may never use. But it's going to have so much information that why not put this into your library? Just knowing how the human body is constructed and the functions of everything, you know, it's going to help a lot, I think, in your art if you can understand your subject a little bit better. So, kitchen anatomy book. I'm sure older ones you can probably find for pretty cheap online. And skulls. My wife got me this one for Christmas one year. And it is just awesome. Who doesn't love skulls? There are so many different types of skulls in here, all different kinds of bird skulls, mammal skulls, fish. Yeah, there's fish skulls in here too. Fantastic reference book. Now, the only problem with this is for almost every skull, there's only one angle. So if you want lots of different angles of the same skull, that might not be the book for you, but just to check out skulls and see what different kinds there are out there. You know, if you see one in the book that you like, you can always Google it and find more information. All right, I'm going to get one more book in here for you guys. This is another instructional book. You can never have too many books on drawing people. Me, personally, you know, if it's something that you struggle with, then why not have as many different viewpoints on it as you can? I don't really draw people very much. So, for me, it's something that's kind of always eluded me. I've enjoyed reading these books, and it's something that I've wanted to practice more. And On occasion, I'll do some figure sketching. But to me, drawing people is one of the hardest things out there. Some people may find it comes naturally to them. They're a lot better at it. Some people may have just practiced more on it growing up than I did. You know, I drew mostly cartoony stuff. So that's something I want to get more into. And like I said, if it's something you're really all about, then you can't have too many books on it. Books are fantastic. You can find a lot on the internet, but I mean, sometimes you just can't beat a good book. So The Art of Drawing People, discover simple techniques for drawing a variety of figures and portraits. Fantastic, fantastic book. So I think that is it for today. I've got some other books that I find inspirational, but we're hitting 26 minutes right now. So I think that's probably long enough for all of you that have stayed this long. Thank you for watching. Next week we're going to go back into another painting video for you. And I'm going to start doing some oil paintings soon. I've already got a few different pieces lined up. Actually, I'll show you one of them right here. Let me get the other half of his face. There we go. I'm going to be doing a 10 by 10 painting of our Boston Terrier, Dillinger. Almost a digital. Yeah, his name is not digital. His name is Dillinger. I'm actually going to do a color painting. This is mainly just to get the lines onto my canvas. And so here I have the 10 by 10 canvas that's going to go onto. So probably going to record that when I start working on it. But I don't really do a whole lot of realistic oil painting, so that was probably going to take me a while. Anyways, that about wraps it up for today's video. Again, thank you to all those of you that stayed this long into it. I promise my next video will not be 30 minutes, but I figured I would give you some insight into some of the books, the reference materials that I enjoy, things that have helped me out along the way. If you want to find some by other artists, there's plenty of stuff out there. Just search YouTube or Google for recommended art books, and you'll find some even better ones. Anyways, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you want to catch my next video and my future videos, please subscribe to my channel. I'll post them every Wednesday around noon. That is it for today. Since I won't see you next week, until next week, have a happy and safe Thanksgiving. And we'll catch you next time. Have a good one.